I've had chronic neck and upper back, lower back problems for a few years.
As a professional golfer and instructor, Brian Guenther is moving in a particular way over and over again each day.
Take a stroll down to the window. Let's see how you're moving today.
For a step in a different direction, he heads to Gisele St. Hilaire.
When I watch him walk, it just gives me a very general idea as to how he is moving in space overall. Because I don't want to just look at his neck. I want to look at how he's organizing his whole being in relation to his neck and his shoulder.
Do you feel this shoulder's higher and this hand is forward?
St. Hilaire is a Feldenkrais practitioner, and that means instead of fixing or mobilizing a joint or stretching a muscle in Brian's neck, she's helping him to reorganize himself based on how that joint connects to the rest of the body.
Sometimes when people move even to go reach for their coffee cup, it is just their arm. And then they do silly things like this and they get neck pain. But if as they reach, their arm's not quite long enough, but that arm's just naturally connected to the rest of them, and in fact even to their feet, they don't end up with their neck pain. It's a little bit easier up here though, isn't it?
Okay. Realizing that all the pieces of our body are connected means that while Guenther is concerned with his neck, St. Hilaire is focused on his hips. And that can be difficult for new clients to comprehend.
It is amazing, like when Gisele moves, you know, certain parts of your body and what you feel in other parts of your body. That was really kind of mind-blowing a little bit.
When I go to lift a shoulder, that does have some relationship or will have some relationship to the way the head and the neck move. And if I'm moving his shoulder with a little forward bend, you can forward bend from the bottom up with his legs. So I think of a whole functional pattern, not just a part.
The reason Feldenkrais is thought of as an educational model rather than a therapy is because it's asking the brain to relearn movement. St. Hilaire explains that as we form our movements from infancy, there is plenty of opportunity for our muscles and limbs and joints to get stuck.
The foundations on which our movements and our actions have been based is a little bit distorted or unclear because there were little bits along our journey that had never got filled out, or because traumas have started to create sort of self-limiting patterns to try to protect ourselves, just like primary lines, and you feel where this line meets that central line.
Working with Guenther, St. Hilaire uncovers those self-limiting patterns and finds potential in the body.
The touch is not so much for him to actually feel me at all. It's much more for him to feel himself in movement, so he begins to feel his own self-limitations and his own potential for movement. So it's more about guiding his attention so that he makes the changes within his own system. There it is, good.
As a Feldenkrais practitioner, St. Hilaire works with clients from infancy to old age and encounters a number of movement disorders from knee injuries to cerebral palsy to stroke recovery. Every session looks different, but in each she is showing the body how to move better so that it truly sinks into the brain.
It lands, it's something that now makes sense. It's like, ah, that is much freer and I feel taller. And then when he walks again, he can feel himself in this new place. So he has a sense of where he came from and a sense of where he is after the lesson. Good.
Guenther's lesson has brought him back to the fairway, the same place that his pain began, but this time he's thinking about how his shoulder is connected to his rib cage, connected to his breastplate, connected to his spine. It's all about global moving patterns that Feldenkrais practitioners like Gisele St. Hilaire are constantly coming back to. If you want to find out more, you can head to her website at sunyatamovementstudio.com. For Go Winnipeg, I'm Kim Kasher.